I think you might be needing this.
Oh, I think you're right, because we are at Aldi, where they ask for a quarter for the cart, which is totally fine because you get the quarter back.
I think it's pretty dumb.
I'm not complaining. And last time we said something, we got a lot of heat.
It's inconvenient.
Anyway, we are at Aldi. We are doing a grocery haul, very highly requested. This is our second Aldi, in fact, because the first one we went to was garbage. They had one thing and we videotaped everything, so we wasted a lot of time. We're redoing it for you. So let's see what they have.
This is a nicer Aldi.
This is a much nicer Aldi. Let's see what they have. Fingers crossed, zero carb bread. Oh, this is a nice one. So, Aldi just came out with a zero carb, net carb bread that we've seen all over Instagram, and we're hoping we find it today. So it's pretty much any low carb bread you'll find online. So they use vital wheat gluten, and some like iffy ingredients if you have gluten intolerance. And
I'll put
like
the macros on screen.
But definitely something that you can fit into your keto diet. Not the best, not a lot of nutrition.
Pretty much the best store-bought version there is though.
Yeah, but no nutrition. So like not something I'm eating every single meal, but if they have it, I'm definitely trying it.
And yeah, this is not what most Aldis look like.
Look at the banana section.
Yeah, most Aldis don't have bananas.
That's better than Whole Foods. You guys have the zero net carb bread here? So we just asked someone and they had the bread for a day. They had 12 cases sold out. So if there's something new in town, you gotta be there first day. The produce here looks really good. I'm not gonna lie. They have some organic stuff as well.
They got a large array of nuts. I love mixed nuts, and look at this, this is cool. It actually says less than 50% peanuts. Because most places sell mixed nuts and it's just all peanuts. But one thing to look for, guys, when you're buying the nuts, look at what if they're fried in oil or like roasted in oil. You don't really want the added oils. So like this has just tons of oils added. Oh, but I would buy these. My grandma actually buys these every Christmas. Full nuts that you need a nutcracker for. We've been to Aldi's where they literally, everything is just like, it looks like it just got raided. It looks like Hurricane Katrina.
No disrespect. They have trail mixes.
These have chocolate in them though. You can make your own pretty easily. Just grab some nuts and like maybe add in some keto-friendly chocolate chips. Make your own trail mix. Ooh, they got this right here. This is nice, raw cashews, walnuts, macadamia nuts. So cashews, those are gonna be the highest carb nut, basically, there is. It's about 7 grams of carbs per quarter cup. But if you mix it in with these other high fat, low carb nuts, you can have a cashew here and there.
So that's a fine, that's a top.
This is a good fine, yeah.
Oh, they still sell these bad boys? Look at that kids dancing, that's exactly what this aisle is.
Yeah.
Just dancing kids.
They got a couple flavors of pork rinds. If there's no oil listed, I just assume it's pork skins and salt. I just assume it's fried in its own fat, pork fat, which is good. That's what you're looking for. So I would get these are A plus.
Some of them are fried in sunflower oil.
Yeah, or just other weird oils. When you start getting the flavored ones though, they usually add some like unsavory stuff in there that you might be afraid of. But like me personally, I would still buy these.
It's so minimal.
A lot of cookies, I mean, they got Samoa knockoffs, which apparently we can't say Samoa cookies anymore. They're called like Coconut Delights
Caramel
or something.
Delights.
Get out of my face. So these are like not terrible. I wouldn't buy them and eat them, but like they're 8 grams of carbs per serving.
Kids?
Yeah, I would get this for Theo.
Oh, cauliflower crackers?
It seems like a lot of people get tricked by things like this because they just see cauliflower or they see like a buzzword like paleo or something and they just assume. You can't assume. You gotta look at the back. Look at the nutrition. That's gonna run you 16 grams of net carbs. That's pretty high, too high for my liking. There's only 4 servings in this box, so it's not crazy. Like, for kids, for Theo, I'd buy these. These are a good alternative.
Yeah, and then they got something that we know for a fact is good. They got Parm crisps here. They got 2 flavors too. These are definitely a find. Popcorn spill. Now this is what we expect of Aldi. They have cage-free eggs.
The cheap stuff for a dollar. That's a good deal, right?
Similar to Walmart. Heavy cream. That's a deal.
That's a big deal. Oh, they have unsweetened almond milk too?
Yep, and they have unsweetened coconut milk.
You gotta make sure it says unsweetened. So this has 1 gram of carbs per cup. Okay, so last time I was in Aldi, they actually have a few decent, right here. So it doesn't taste the best, but as far as like a grab and go beef jerky, you can't find beef jerky with no carbs in stores really. The entire bag 1 gram. This is like my least favorite kind.
Summer sausage.
Just like, do you guys like that?
No.
Comment below.
No.
I don't like it. If you get it in like a gift basket, it's the last thing I would eat. But yeah, like these are great. Less than 1 gram of carb. The thing is, like, the ingredients are probably not gonna be the best. That's a good on-the-go snack. Plus, it doesn't seem like it needs to be refrigerated. Just keep these in your car.
In the glove box during the summer.
What a jokester over here.
It's the mom in me.
These are not bad. For beef jerky, 5 carbs. That's like as good as you'll find.
Because I don't just like 3 pieces.
I'd eat it in a pinch.
I would not. I think it's personal preference.
Oh, I want to get a thunder shot.
Not a solid find, but Matt is into thunder shots.
Red thunder.
So he's gonna take a thunder shot.
I've never actually had a 5-hour energy. Have you?
Yeah.
Do they work?
I had one on our wedding day. I didn't tell you.
Oh.
This is 138 milligrams of caffeine.
That's kind of a lot.
Sucralose, potassium sorbate, natural flavors. But if you need energy, thunder shot's the way to go.
Go thunder shot or go home. So they have the worst coffee known to man right here.
You're joking. It's really good.
So I'm big on olives as a snack lately. And I like getting the ones with the pit. It's hard to find the ones with the pit. They got a lot of selection here. Yeah, they don't really have anything that I'm looking for. Yeah, maybe these. Yeah. I'll get a few of these.
How did you decide?
Basically, these are the only ones they sell that aren't stuffed with things, so that's how I decided. Some
and
dressings.
They got a ton of dressings.
It's hard for me to imagine they'll have anything with like good oils.
So you see the canola oil. Canola oil or sunflower oil is gonna be the main.
Or soybean oil.
Or soybean oil is gonna be the main.
What you want is olive or avocado, and none of these are gonna have it.
Yeah.
I would consider these to be like pretty bad. Like, to me, these are like
on the inflammation scale.
Just on the health scale, like these are a bag of potato chips to me, essentially. If you want to make one small upgrade, like yeah, these are technically keto friendly. The first small upgrade to your diet, in my opinion, should be avoid the terrible vegetable oils. Start using like olive oil, avocado oil.
Yeah.
Upgrade number one.
And it comes at a cost, but it's also your health. What's a twist board?
You need one. You stand on it and you twist for a workout.
Looks like it's perfect for postpartum moms.
It's cousins with a shake weight.
Oh, look.
Oh, I just got a find.
I got another find.
Oh my gosh. Theo is gonna be a baby model. Look at that, ew. That baby? Someone just got a find.
I know, but
are
they're probably
kidding?
Not that good. They're probably
$3.99 for this
they
candle?
They probably don't make the room smell like
get it. We gotta take a shot,
you
though.
You know I only like $24.99 candles
I know
from
that.
Bath & Body Works. Oh, they have Elevation protein powder. All right, guys. So the Elevation bars, they're like Quest bars, but Aldi brand. So this is a type, and then we got these chewy ones over here.
Which one do people like best on Instagram?
I think people like this one.
Yeah, you can see here it says 2 grams of net carbs.
Yep.
This one here says one gram
of
sugar. This looks like a Power Crunch knockoff.
It does. So let's go with the Power Crunch. 8 carbs, which is also the Power Crunch carbs.
This one's actually not bad.
The white chocolate is made with maltitol.
3 grams of sugar alcohols, but that's factored into the 8. So it's still reasonable for keto.
Okay. These Elevation ones, like the crunchy ones.
Yeah.
Then these are the ones that people always rave about, the 2 grams net carbs.
They're super small.
Yeah, they're
like this.
They're very tiny. Let's see what we're working with. So 17 total carbs, 5 fiber, 10 sugar alcohols, and that's 10 grams of maltitol. I'm saying no.
I agree.
This is not 2 grams of net carbs by any means.
More like 12 to 15.
Yeah.
Love myself a good canned meat section. And what I'm looking for is usually sardines, oysters. Oysters are my fave. Thing is, you're at a store like this, I'm assuming they're not gonna have any in olive oil. That's what I like to get. Seafood in olive oil. Oysters in cottonseed oil, though. So
that's weird that they advertise it.
Yeah, I would not get these. So this is kind of a bust, actually, because usually they'll at least have sardines in water, which I don't like the taste of, but it's going to be the like cleanest. Cleanest is dumb, but cleanest.
An option. All right, so we got a candy section. Let's see if they have any really dark chocolate. Doesn't look like they have any dark chocolate. So when we're looking, we usually go 85% and up. So 85%, I'm gonna say, like, I was never a dark chocolate person, like way too bitter for me. But now 85% tastes really sweet to me. And it usually has a good amount of fiber, but it doesn't look like they have any here. They got good deals on stuff. That cream cheese is really cheap. Bacon's pretty cheap.
Yeah, nothing's really catching my eye that I want to buy, though.
Yeah, we're not big on hot dogs, but I know a lot of people do like them, and kids like them. But, like, let's look at these kielbasa.
The deals, though, are really phenomenal.
Yeah, great deals for sure.
Like, look at this. They got this big pack of turkey bacon for less than $2. Well, 79
because no one likes turkey bacon. Not great ingredients in this kielbasa, but 2 carbs per 2 ounces. Not bad. Like, I think of, like, camping even. Like, just grill this up. So it looks like they have a gluten-free section, which is really cool. But gluten-free does not mean low carb.
A little bit of a standout star at Aldi is this section here. Nice little snack. Me and Mega always get stuff like this when we go on planes. We share them. I would just throw these breads away. And like, I used to feel bad. I'm like, oh man, I'm wasting the breads. But it's really just like very cheap. Like these breads right here, they're worth like 3 cents probably.
Don't even feed them to the seagulls or anything because they're just getting diabetes too. What about this guy, this little veggie tray right here with cheese?
Yeah, they got a, oh, that's a solid veggie tray. I wouldn't eat the ranch because it's vegetable oils.
But you could. Yeah, that's still a great find.
Oh, they got more olives. They're all pitted though. But these look better. Check the oil they're in. Okay, in olive oil. A lot of times they're in canola oil. They are. See? You gotta be, you can't read it, but it says canola oil right there. And they're advertising on the front. Olive oil. They're trying to trick you guys. You gotta take your health into your own hands. Read the ingredients. So yeah, this section is actually quite good. All these things are like knockoffs though, because like Parmesan cheese, this isn't actually Parmesan cheese. Like Parmesan cheese is a protected product and it should have a stamp that says like this is from Italy. This doesn't, but still it tastes like 90% as, not 90, it tastes like 60% as good. And it's like 20% the price.
It's great for keto.
Even though this is fake prosciutto, it tastes good. You could fool me, right? We went to Italy and we spent how much on that one slice of prosciutto? It's like 20 bucks.
Yeah.
Because the guy was like, this has been aged for like 6 years. They pour wine on the inside.
And it was phenomenal.
Like, it was really good. So we've had like the best prosciutto there is. But still, for a snack, this is $3. I'll do it all day. I'm going to load up on this, actually.
We're going to get haters for sure, all the Italians. Oh, you're loading up. Energy shot
this
followed by
too.
Prosciutto.
This is good. Spec Italiano.
But look, they got like a lot of different ones. They got salami. They got just a lot of good meats that you can browse.
I mean, the prices are just ridiculous. Shredded Parmesan cheese, $2. And something I like to do, you're making like a little statement purchase. Like Mega thought I would get like one or two of these. I'm getting 5. I like to throw it in, then I go like this.
Like these are my favorite types of things. Like especially before I was keto, like tubs of just like chicken salad, macaroni salad, whatever. So this is buffalo chicken bacon cheddar dip. I mean, great for like parties having, but the downside is the mayo they're gonna use in all types of salads. Even if you think it's keto friendly, the mayo uses soybean oil, so then it's just like bad vegetable oils. It's definitely keto friendly, like you can consume it. Let's see what the macros are actually.
Keto friendly doesn't always mean healthy.
Right, so this is 1 carb per 2 tablespoons. So yes, great for keto in the sense like it's low carb, it's high fat, but the fat contains vegetable oils, which aren't great.
These are good for a party. Brie, we actually have a cool recipe where you cut the top off of the brie and you fill it with like delicious meats and then you bake it.
Yeah, we have like a taco one.
Good appetizer for a party. And we have the brie cups we make too. Mm-hmm. So you take prosciutto, you put it in a mini cupcake tin.
Yep.
You put brie inside and then a raspberry on top.
Or you can do pecan. I like pecans better. And then look, they got a tray like this. This is great for like parties or like kids' afternoon snacks. You can pack it in their lunch bags if they're taking an ice pack, or you can do it for yourself.
These look
Bavarian bratwurst are usually pretty good.
Yeah, they are good.
No, they're good like macro-wise.
And taste-wise.
So 4 carbs, 3 fiber per link.
3 fiber, it must just be like a lot of spices and maybe some veggies.
Yeah, so 1 net carb, salt, spices, dextrose.
So all sausages basically you're gonna buy are gonna have dextrose. But to us, and to most people, most reasonable people, it's not a big deal.
Right, it's minimal. They got just like a whole oven roasted turkey, which is great. You can slice it up yourself. The sugar in the rub, but it's 1 carb per 2 ounces. So again, a very small amount, but
I'd buy it.
Yeah, exactly. What about the chicken strips right here?
Oh, these are phenomenal.
Yeah.
These are great. Grilled chicken with rib meat, chili sauce, fresh onions, and bell peppers.
Camera's about to die.
It is? We don't have more batteries for it.
Why wouldn't you bring another battery?
So, the camera ran out of batteries, but they actually have a decent looking seafood section, but I'm kind of skeptical. So, you'll see these scallops. They're the size of my fist. I feel weird about them, although...
They're jumbo.
They're jumbo, And there, it says certified sustainable seafood. On the back here, it says wild caught. I don't know though. Why are they this huge and perfect looking, I guess is my question, but they were 10 bucks. Then I guess the best way to end the video is with a Thunder energy shot. Shake around all the vitamins.
I thought you were gonna chug it.
Comment below with what you have at your Aldi, since they're all wildly different. Is yours a really nice Aldi in the nice part of town? And let us know if you find the bread. If you found the bread, if you tried it, comment below, give us a full review, bite by bite review. And if you guys want to check out the blog post below, we have compiled more details about what you can find at what Aldi's and what areas, and some things to look for. So check out the blog post, share it with your friends. Thanks for watching.